Tennessee, getting right back into it again. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to our Let's Play of Bushido Blade 2 on the Ninja Stalker. Okay. I want more PS1 games to play. I just don't know which ones to play. Because the worst thing about me, I'll go ahead and explain this to you, to anyone who's watching, all my viewers. The worst thing about me is that I am absolutely picky. Now, the good and bad thing about being picky, one, you get what you're looking for. Two, you have to go through all the stuff that you don't want that you perceive as something bad. So towards everyone else, to others people, to other people's eyes, what you don't like, they're probably going to be like, why don't you like that? And then they should take into account and consideration, oh, well, what's good for someone might not be good for someone else. It's almost like the reverse of when someone says one man's trash is another man's treasure. Well, it almost makes it that much sweeter for you when you're the individual who's being picky to go for something that you like. Now, at the same time, there's a very thin line of when you're picky and then there's selfishness. And you have to be careful with that. Now, I do as best as I can, but the thing is, you just heard me earlier say, I want more PS1 games to play. I'm running this PS emulator, this EPSXE. I can pretty much download any game on the internet that they have as an ISO onto this computer to play as a PS1 game, so to say. Problem is, I always go online and I'm like, ah, great PS1 games, and I do this just about every few weeks just to see what there is, but I've already seen all the games that they had. I'm just hoping for something good to pop up and say, hey, pick me, and I'm like, ah, I don't know if I want to play you. Like, for example, my sister went ahead a while ago and told me, why don't you play some Lara Croft games, right? Lara Croft Tomb Raiders. I used to play those games when I had an actual PS1. I had a 1, 2, did I have 3? I don't know. I actually quite a few of them, in all honesty. I didn't think I had too many, but I actually had a few. There was a Tomb Raider Revelations. There was a Tomb Raider something. Last Crusade, does that sound right? No, I don't know what I'm talking. I had quite a few of them. The only problem with those games is I never beat a single Tomb Raider game, and it's because those games, to me, I don't know about to you, but to me, they are super fucking hard. Oh, it just irks me, it just pisses me off. The only thing I liked about it was that you got to play as a girl, and she was actually a pretty attractive individual. I mean, Lara Croft. Then again, of course, it's PS1 graphics, some polygon graphics, you know what I'm talking about? Doesn't leave too much for the imagination nowadays, but back then, dude, she was hot, and she had a British accent. Oh my god. But yeah, the little Tomb Raider game's not what I'm looking for, even though I know that they're a good game. Another good game I would like to try, but then at the same time I don't know, is the Medieval. I never played Medieval. I've seen it played on YouTube, and I was like, hey, I'd like to try doing a Let's Play on that one day, but then I realized I've never played it, and I don't know much about it, but that still doesn't stop me from doing a blind Let's Play here and there. I've done a blind Let's Play or two on my channel. I just don't know. Some games are like, yeah, totally play me, and then others are not. Here's another PS1 game. I know we're on this screen, by the way, that says load data from memory card, and I'm just going off on a tangent, but I want you to hear me out on all these games I like to try, and then, you hear from me, and then, I don't know, maybe, you can comment somewhere at the bottom saying, hey, try this game or that game. But then at the same time, I don't want it to be a waste of time for people when they do that, because what if you suggest a game, right? What if you suggest a game, and then I'm like, ah, I don't know if I want to play that, or ah, I don't want to play that. And then all of a sudden, I made you waste your time, and then I hate doing that, I like to make sure that the time is always on a constant, nice flow going forward. Now, of course, I can't control everything, especially for the fact that I choose to go in the military. There's no way I can control everything going in the military. Even if I go in as a warrant officer, and warrant officers are pretty much officers, they get to have some sort of command and control to an extent, because the thing between warrant officers and officers are general individuals, they're general officers. They're the ones who get to command and control. They get to lead, advise, console, and all that other stuff. That's their main priority as an officer, because as they what do they say in the military, you know, you're always a soldier, then you are what your MOS is, and then you're also whatever else you're supposed to be. It gets kind of convoluted for the military, but warrant officers, they don't lead command control as much as you would think as officers do. They can, and they have several times, but it's not a common thing to see. It's almost a rarity to see a warrant officer of any rank, because you got warrant officer 01, so W01, and then you got chief warrant officer 2. This is for all you individuals who don't know much about the military. I'm going ahead and explaining to you. Then you got chief warrant officer 2, you know, CW02 or just CW2, and then you got chief warrant officer 3, chief warrant officer 4, chief warrant officer 5. And they don't get to do that as much as the officers do, because officers, again, are the general officers. They're the general grade individuals that get to do that job. Well, so then you're probably wondering, all right, then so what would be the point of being a warrant officer when you could be an officer to do that other stuff? Well, you remember how I explained earlier I want to be a pilot for the Army? That's where warrant officers come in to really shine. Now, it's not just pilots. They do have warrant officers in the medical field, I believe. They have warrant officers in the technical field. So that's basically what they are. They're technical experts, right? They're the experts. They're the professionals of their field. There is nobody better than them in the military for what they do when they have them in that field. They are specialists, basically. So you'll have officer pilots, and then you have warrant officer pilots. Out of the two, the people that you want to learn from the most, if it's going to be about flying and being a pilot and all that, you're going to want to go to a warrant officer over an officer. Now, granted, you'll probably have officers who have been at that MOS for a very long time, but the thing is, they don't get to fly as much, and they don't get to be in that field as much as a warrant officer. Hence why warrant officers are the technical experts. They're the professionals. They are just the specialists of the field. You'll want to go to them because they get to fly more often than officers. They get to know more about their aircraft than an officer does, you know? So you would want it to be like that. So I guess in regard for gaming like this, you know, you can't control everything, but I get to do as much as I can. And again, like with warrant officers and officers, I don't get to control much. I can lead, I can advise, I can counsel when they teach me to, and I pray to God, oh, I so pray to God that I can make it past warrant officer candidate school. I'ma give it my damnedest, right? Because it was a bitch and a half for me to get my degrees, but I went and got them with A's and B's. You know, I got my associate's degree of science and my bachelor's degree of humanities. Both of those specifically I picked to just go into the military and show them, hey, I really want to be part of you guys. I really want to be an officer of some type. And then I was like, you know what? I want to be a warrant officer with this and a pilot. They're like, oh, right, cool. I like that. I like to see people like you coming in for the military, to volunteer for the military, to be for the military instead of just using us for money or prestige or this and that. I'm like, oh, best believe. That's why they loved me at the the officers board, you know, because I spoke the truth. I didn't want to make like I was just brown nosing. You don't ever want to do that, especially if they catch you. Ooh, you fucked, straight up. Because then they're just gonna be like, oh yeah, totally. We'll call you when we want you, and then they're gonna look at your recruiters and be like, mm. But no, they liked me. I was like, oh, that is awesome. That is beautiful. And they're like, yeah, man, whatever you did great. I was like, I was just me. I was myself. And they're like, that's perfect. We didn't even have to tell you. We didn't have to prepare you. We didn't even have to prepare you for that. Because some recruiters do that, which is not bad, but they knew I was okay. They knew I was okay. And I was like, oh, this is awesome. I like this. So, you know, again, I'm praying that I can get past the warrant officer candidate school, and I'm going to give it my damnedest. If I make it, oh, that'd be awesome. But for something like this, to find a good game, because I've noticed some of my games, I'm coming up to close to finishing up and all that, but I mean, I'm trying to look for a good PlayStation game, because what's another good PlayStation game? There's Spyro, right? Spyro, Ripto's Rage. I played that before. I didn't play the first one, but Ripto's Rage I've played. I don't know if I want to play that again, though. That game's a long game, too. Ooh, I remember that took me, like, years to finish. Let me just go ahead and load. What else is there? Trying to think, what are some other games? Now, I did play as Tony on the Shinto team, so now I gotta switch over to Narukagami, and I gotta play somebody from there. Fuck, but who do I want? What's another good game? Because the thing is, I love the PlayStation games. That was just, like, my era of gaming, you know? Because I had a Super Nintendo, but I didn't play much. As a matter of fact, I think, what kind of games? I had Super Mario World, Super Mario Brothers, Super Mario World for the SNES. There was the Pink Panther game. There was James Bond Jr. There was I didn't have very many games for the Super Nintendo, but when the PlayStation came out and fortunate enough, one of my parents got it for me because one of them didn't want it for me. That woman. She's good and all, but I mean, come on now. How are you going to say games are terrible for kids when you can learn from games? You can really do learn from games. You got your hand-eye coordination. You especially got attention to detail. I can't tell you how many times when I worked for the U.S. government over at the nearest base of me, right? As a civilian, and we worked at a place where we handed out equipment like computers. We handed out games for them to go and enjoy video game systems on. You know, we started with 360s and PS3s, then we moved up to PS4s and Xbox One. So we had we had like 16 stations, each with a gaming system that you could come in and play with for as long as you want. You know. Now, of course, it'll get jam-packed, crowded in there when people all want to come in and play a system. So then it's like, well, you know, you gotta wait because we can't just go and kick this guy off just so you can play. Because guess what? It'll happen to you when someone else wants to come in and play, you know? You want me to give him 10 minutes? I gotta go and give you 10 minutes afterwards. And you gotta understand that I gotta do that to you. So then everyone got to understanding, all right, you know, I probably won't get a chance to play. Can I bring my own system in? And we were like, I don't know, what do we do? And I straight up told them, fuck yeah, bring your stuff in. And everyone looked at me and I was like, hey, it's about the customers, am I right? We let them have a place to come in and play their own stuff because we got the, you know, we got the outlets that could bring their own TVs and stuff. We got the food. We make money off of that, you know? Don't look at the customers as dollar signs. Look at them as this is for them. And we have what can satisfy their needs. And then people were like, yeah, you know, let's do that. Anyways, So we had stuff like that, and the one thing I would notice is when we had soldiers who didn't have a high perception or attention to detail, and you can easily tell just by walking around, checking on the gaming consoles while checking the soldiers play these gaming systems, and you could tell the good ones from the bad ones. Obviously, the bad ones are the ones that are dying a lot, the ones who are missing things here and there. They're just playing a game just to play a game, which, you know, that's fine. They can do that, you know? Don't really judge, but when you really watch these people, you're like, you know, just to think about it, this individual's about this age, they really didn't get a chance to play video games when they were younger, and if they did, they didn't really take into account to play a video game to understand a video game. They just played a video game just to play it. Whereas me, when I was younger, when I played a video game and I started dying a lot, I was trying to figure out real quick and real soon, why am I dying a lot? What am I doing wrong? What am I missing? What do I have to do to get past this? Now, those individuals, if you are that individual or you have a high perception where you're always looking around every nook and cranny and stuff like that, I do that a lot. If you don't believe me, look at any of my other playlists, any of my games. I go anywhere and everywhere just to make sure I don't miss something. Even if it's a dead end, I go to make sure that there's nothing at that dead end. Because sometimes, some video games teach you, dead ends are not exactly empty, or like empty-handed, you know, though you might find something. Prime example, off the top of my head, Demon Souls. There was a lot of dead ends in Demon Souls, but guess what? You can find some items in those dead ends. It wasn't a complete dead end now, was it? Anyways, I was watching these soldiers, right? And I was like, man, some of these guys don't have a high perception or attention to detail, you know? And then you would find the ones that have high attention to detail, high perception. They were the ones that weren't dying as often. They were finding things, they were going to places. Hell, they were even explaining things to other people. Like, yeah, see, you gotta go here and go and do this. And then people be like, have you played this game before? Fuck no. Oh, okay, cool, wow, okay, that's great. It's interesting, but... Let me see, who do we wanna... You know what? Red Shadow. I mentioned I wanted to try Red Shadow. Alright, so we got this beautiful girl. Fuck, I don't have my phone on me. And my phone is in my room, and that's like a bitch and a half to get to. That's literally a fucking mile to get to my room. It's literally not a mile. I just said that because sometimes I over-exaggerate. Can you fucking imagine a mile to get to your room? Either you're in a rich-ass house, a big old mansion or something, or you got something wrong going on, you know? But it is a distance away. Currently, I'm lazy. It's really not that distance away. Again, I'm over-exaggerating, but... Man... I'm trying to figure out what weapons is good. What weapons has great combos with this fine-ass bitch, Red Shadow? Ah, crap. She's fast, too, so she'd probably be good with the katana. Then there's the Nodachi. Then you got the broadsword. I don't know if she's good with the broadsword. But then you got the longsword. Ah, damn it. Shit. Alright, I'm going to my room. I'm going. I know what some of y'all are saying. Just go to your fucking room. Get your phone. Alright, I'm going. I'll be right back. The internet, and then my cat decides to fucking attack my feet. I'm just walking by, and he's like, what up, bitch? And I'm like, no, why? Why, Leo? I'm telling you, my cat, he's straight up gangster, that cat. He's not exactly a fat yellow tabby, but he's a beefy. Let's say he's a beefy, you know, like his head is smaller than his body, so it gives the illusion that he's fat, but he's really not. I mean, the cat weighs like anywhere from 15 to maybe 18 pounds, which isn't much when you Google online for fat cats, you'd be surprised. Again, you got cats that are 20 pounds or more or something, you know. No, my cat, actually, I don't even know if he's a yellow tabby, in all honesty. I mean, he's a short-haired, short fur, whatever you want to call that. Striped, you know, he's got some stripes on him. But he's, like, yellowish, very, very light yellow, almost white, but it's not white. You can tell, you know, that he's got yellow on him. He'll have, like, patches of lighter yellow that looks white, but it's not, you know what I'm saying? And he's got like very special eyes too. Sometimes they're blue, sometimes they're green, sometimes they're a darker shade of yellow, you know? It's pretty cool. Pretty cool. He's a badass though. He'd be attacking, you know? Okay, so I got my phone, and I fixed the internet, at least I hope I fixed the internet. If not, my sister will come in here and fuck me up or something. Which is funny, too, because she's younger than me, but usually whenever she says something, you gotta do it. She's only younger than me by 1 year, though, so. Shit, why did I do that? I straight up went to my phone, right? And I was supposed to go to Google Chrome, and I was telling myself, Google Chrome. But immediately on my phone, I looked up at Imgur, and I clicked on Imgur as if I was gonna go to Imgur. Okay. Oh, hey, what do you know? It's on the page that I left off at. Okay, so. Red Shadow. What are you good with, Red Shadow? I think when I looked online, it said Red Shadow was Russian or something. I was like, word? What? Not. Okay, that's what it's called. You got Kanuki, Mikado, Touchdown, versus that. Wait, what? What the fuck? Wait a minute. Something ain't right. Something ain't right. We got, okay, so we have Kanuki, Mikado, Tatsumi, versus that. Gachi, Night Stalker, Sanzuka, Hokyu. Who the hell is that? Hokyuko? Is that supposed to be her? They just named her that differently? Hokyuko? What the fuck? What the fuck? Well, it wouldn't matter anyways. Apparently the only good person with the Naginata, or Naginata, whatever, is, Mikado, apparently. Let's see. Claymore. Doesn't have a combo. Let me see if this person has. Problem for Red Shadow, we don't know what her specials are. Fuck. pop a save there and see what happens. Alright, so we pop the save. We'll see what combos she has for what weapons. This is gonna be terrible. Also, if you're wondering why the screen looks a little different in color, it's a type of, maybe like computer mod to help with the eyes hurting or whatever. Alright, so she doesn't really have much. Let's go to the broadsword or the claymore that has a cross on it. That would be probably my choice of weapon when you got like demons coming up from hell and zombies all over the place. That's my weapon. I'll be sending all these fuckers back straight to hell. You know what I'm saying? About to die from a fine bitch. There we go. Okay, so she did some crazy thing. Them legs though, man. She got like bigger, stronger legs than most of these guys. You see this? She be like that one chick that can squish a fucking, squish a fucking watermelon between her legs, man. You don't want to fuck with that. But then maybe. You catch what I'm saying. So, no doubt, somebody out there's probably got a fetish like that. They'll be like, man, I like me some strong women. He just got stabbed. Like, he saw it happen. He was like, feed me it. And then she's like, alright. Oh, shit. I didn't mean it like that. Alright, so there's that. And then that. Shit. Dumbass, that's what you get. Whoa there. Oh, yes. The blood just rained all over the place.
The Shinto has become careless because they believe we...
Hold up, because we're going to roll back. But I need to see what else is there, because I feel as though we didn't check everything.
Set!
Okay, so she had a special sword there. It didn't look like she got, chopped up right there. Yeah, see, it looked like he got her in the head, but the blood came out of the torso. Anyways, we're rolling back. Let's check the katana out. So we have the Claymore as a possibility to use, which we might. It depends on how the other weapons are. We might just roll back to the Claymore, but first let's check out the other weapons to see how our combos are. Okay, so she can have two swords, as you can see. But when it comes to actually using them, she doesn't actually use them both. Okay, so there's... Bitch. Alright, so she doesn't have combos for this weapon. An Odachi? That is one curved-ass sword. You see that? But it doesn't look like that in the actual gameplay. That would actually bug me in real life with a sword like that. Like, I have one in my room, but it's just a katana, and I don't remember the length of it, though. Okay, so there wasn't much for that. Longsword? Oh, okay, so it's the long sword that she can have two weapons with. That's interesting. And apparently I get taught a very valuable lesson of life right there. Sometimes it'll just come up and bite you in the ass. Or chop your head off. He wasn't having any of that. Okay, so there's that. He wasn't having any of that either.
Yokumo doushou. Rainのため.
Alright, so we can either use the longsword or the broadsword. Both of which seems as though that they have that same little combo that they do where she rolls on the ground and chops at your ankles or whatnot. And then there's that one combo where she like does a fake out, but then she strikes either once or twice depending on which buttons you push. The other thing is with the longsword, she gets the added benefit. She gets the added benefit of using two swords at the same time with this one. This one she does not. But I suppose the difference being is this is a bigger, heavier weapon. It's also, you know, longer, and then this one, she can have two swords. So I don't know which one of these we would go with. Which one of these should we go with? I want to go with this because it's going to be an obvious thing that you want two weapons out on the battlefield, you know, because you'll have two over somebody else. The negative side to looking at that is sometimes having two weapons isn't that beneficial. There are still ways to get around somebody using two weapons. Like, I think a perfect example is one of the Bruce Lee movies. He had a nunchuck. Or two nunchucks, or one nunchuck, I can't remember, and someone else had one or two swords, and even though it is a movie, Bruce Lee just went and just beat the shit out of that dude. I think at the end, he, like, got him by the neck, held him down, while the guy threw his own sword for some reason. Oh, no, he didn't throw his own sword. I think Bruce Lee hit him to where his sword flew up in the air because he tried to strike at him after they were, like, beating the shit out of each other, or mostly Bruce Lee beating the shit out of him. And then Bruce Lee looked up real quick, grabbed his nunchucks, grabbed the guy by his neck, and then pulled his head down so where it looked like he's like leaning over or bowing, right? And then he saw the sword come down in slow motion, you know, and it's like, yeah, and this thing is screwing up. I think I want to go with the big sword. Let's go with the broadsword. Looks like it'll do a whole lot of damage. It'll make her slower, but it's not like I'm running too much in this game anyways. Oh, and then there's that. I forgot you can do that. You couldn't do that with the two swords. So I guess that's a trade-off. You can have two swords or you can do that. Sometimes it'll cut, sometimes it won't. Yeah, that little fake out. Ah, you piece of shit. See, but that's the thing you gotta worry about, that heavy sword. It takes a while to react. Dude, screw you. Doing a maneuver like that, yeah, you're gonna work your squats. Look at that, dude. You'd be working your legs out doing this. Go for them ankles. Go for them ankles. There we go. Now finish him. Ah, damn. Go for them ankles again. Ah, that would have been perfect. No, no, don't do that. Okay. Okay, hold up. Wait. I got an idea. Wait, hold up. Okay, so that's that. That's forward, back, X. So then that means we want to do back, forward. Go for them ankles. Okay, alright. And then forward, back. Ah, shit. Y'all, you know what I'm trying to do, right? Watch, just watch. Just watch me. Just watch. Watch. Alright, so we go for ankles, and then forward, back. Forward, back. Yeah! So you can, like, trip them and then cut them while they're coming up. Okay, so that didn't have a... So, only in the high stance you can have combos, I guess. What a good ending.
The Shinto has become careless because they believe we are lacking warriors. Now, the time is ripe to attack.
We all know that the Shinto headquarters is located on that island. It's clear then, I am the one who will go.
I will go and investigate. I have an advantage. It will be difficult for the Shinto to sense my presence.
I was about to say, what's your advantage? Are you gonna tell? Apparently, just like Night Stalker, she's a ninja. Which we know this from before. Part of the Koga clan. Be jumping over me. Oh, that is awesome. You saw that? Hold up. Hold up. Aw, man. Ah, damn it. I thought that was going to cut him by the... Never mind. What a stab. Alright, who do we have? Highwayman.
That's strange. I didn't realize there was someone like you in the Shinto.
Indeed. People know me as Highwayman.
Well, people are gonna know you as a dead man, too. How about that? Okay, he wasn't having any of that whatsoever. Come on. Just trip him. There we go. Shit, I thought that was gonna work. Okay, so he took up the high stance. Oh, come on. No, don't do that. Not that. No. Oh, as soon as I saw that, I was like, fuck. Alright, you. Round two, bitch. Okay, and I let that one happen. I was like, oh, what's he gonna do? Gee, I wonder. Damn you! Okay, that's fucked up. And I pretty much just stood there and let it happen too. I was just like, yeah, got him, but I lost an arm. Like, the reason why I wait a lot is, don't think like I'm a terrible player. I try to calculate these things out. And what I was trying to do there is find an opening. And the opening is...
I didn't imagine I would be able to return to the Meikyokan.
Wait, was he in?
Or to see Master Utsusemi again.
Hey, Red Shadow. I didn't think you were coming back.
Kanuki, it's you. What are you doing here? I thought you weren't supposed to show up until later on.
Can't you ever be nice? I came here to help you out. But I know you. I'm willing to bet you're planning to do this all alone.
Do you really believe that I would proceed so recklessly?
So, I was right. Well, I guess I'll lend you a hand for now. See ya.
But yeah, usually I try to look for an opening. It's those preemptive strikes, you know. You have to wait for them to, like, attack, and then that's when you attack. Something like that. But the problem is, if you're slow, it ain't gonna help any.
Please, allow me to fight.
よくもどうしよう。
Good color you picked for your uniform there. You can see the blood all over.
I will accept your challenge.
This dude. Okay. Get shit out of here.
I am sorry, Kanuki. I must hurry.
She almost made it sound like he didn't die, he's just hurt. I don't know. I don't know. Get that shit out of here.
Yokumotoshio.
Get that shit out of here. You want to jump too? You want me to color up that purple uniform?
Set.
Get
that shit out of here. There's a lot of jumpers for some reason. Get out of here. Damn it.
Oh,
what you got? Show me an opening. No! No! Ah. It's like you saw me fuck up too with me. It's like, no! 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 That's too good. That's too good. Hold on to that for me.
You.
Your body will be the sheath.
I cannot believe that it's you who is fighting.
I'm Chihiro. But you already know that. Ninjas know everything, don't they?
I know that you're about to die, son. Or girl. They say that it's a guy in like the American version, but I think in the... What the fuck? But in like the Japanese version, it's a female. Give me that frog.
Ha! Ha! There.
Apparently she doesn't like frogs. You saw how she freak out? Ha! Here, take that frog. Oh, she don't mind. He or she don't mind frogs.
There. Set. Yeah. Set. Yeah.
Oh god, she almost got my feet there. What are you doing with a frog in your pants anyways, dude? Seriously. You know, that's how you get warts? That's disgusting. It's either a frog or a toad. I don't know. It's just I wouldn't touch either one of them. Don't do that! Okay, alright. I thought he was gonna... Oh, shit. Back up. Ah, damn it. I'm having trouble with a kid. Get that shit out of here. Just fucking die.
Set.
You bitch. I can't throw my sword at him, but hey. Damn, why didn't that cut him? This bitch. Oh, almost. No! Gotcha!
I never thought I could defeat the Shinto's successor here. Leave! You are not wanted here!
That won't happen. You see, Katse is a persistent guy.
Katse's about to be a dead guy. He was like, fuck that shit.
What a waste of time.
Even though you died earlier.
Looks like you're safe.
Likewise.
Perhaps I asked too much of you.
Not at all. As long as I can be of service to you.
You never change.
It's because he likes you, fool.
People do not change easily. However, my skills have improved. Please, allow me to demonstrate for you.
Nah, I'm saving here. Because if he dies, I'm going to be sad. I feel as though the spirit of Night Stalker's in me. Even though that sounds totally weird. Let me look and see. Does Night Stalker have any specials with this weapon? He doesn't. Fuck! Alright, Night Stalker, we going in blind. Die, don't die. That shit. So there's nothing with that. Don't do that, don't do that, don't do that. Oh god. Oh god, oh Jesus. Okay, so then... Okay, so you can stab. Does he really not have a single combo? Oh, nice. You caught him in midair.
よくもどうしよう。はい。よくもどうしよう。
I guess he doesn't have any combos. We're gonna have to deal with the original, regular combos
here. I will
here.
Face you to the best of my abilities.
I have great respect for you, because of your ninjutsu. I shall give it my all.
Alright, let's see what happens. Okay, you know what? That didn't happen, you know? Shit. Okay, you know what? I don't know what to say. I just don't know what to say. Damn you! Oh, come on! Ah, damn you! Nice! Bitch, that's what you get. Even though I died 2 or 3 times.
Red Shadow, it's now up to you to finish the rest.
Well, it looks like the best was saved for last.
You don't appear to be a typical ninja. I, Gengoro, will not let you pass.
It's usually Gengoro's last. And he died super easy! Oh my god. Wow.
Only the Shinto headquarters remains now.
That's a first. Oh my goodness. Shinto.
So, you are the last one. In order to protect the Meikyokan, I will defeat you.
I am the Shinto leader, Iragi Daina. Now, come.
Nope, oh, that didn't work. Oh, it worked that time, okay.
Master Utsusemi, I, Red Shadow, have returned.
Fool! Don't hand me that I have returned. I had asked you to protect us, not to go off on your own acting recklessly.
Forgive me, Master, but to protect everyone concerned, I thought it was the best way. It was never my intention to disobey you.
Well, I do have faith in you, and you have served me with loyalty. By the way, Red Shadow, I've given much thought to the idea of starting up the Meikyokan all over again. Why don't you help me?
Yes! If that is your wish.
Well, just don't be so foolhardy next time. But then, I guess there won't be a next time.
Yes. Finally, it really is over.
There are plans in the work, ladies and gentlemen. Start up the Meikyokan all over again. So like, what, a new dojo? Kind of place for people to learn the ways of Bushido. It's interesting. I like that. That's cool. Alright, so there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for watching. You guys have all been great. Take care, and you guys have yourselves a great day. Hold up, first of all, I said a great day, should have been a good night, but, Let me see. Who do we have left? Okay, so out of the Narukagami, we have... Alright, we completed everyone on this side. We have Master... Or, excuse me, not Master. We have, Masamuchi. We have this person. Okay, so we have three left on this team, plus the gunner. And then on this team, we have this piece of crap. We have, this person, and yeah. So we have three on each team, and then the two gunmen. Or gun people, I should say. So yeah, it's good. Alright, there you have it. Thanks for watching. You guys take care. Have a great night.